age doesn't mean anything, because at any age, if you learn that negative feelings make your image shrink to the size of a small potato, and if you learn to turn your back on the failures of the past and concentrate on the confidence of yesterday and use that confidence today, now, N-O-W, in your present undertaking, you will learn how to succeed in life. If you call upon your past successes, you succeed. If, on the other hand, you call upon your past failures, you fail even before you start, simply because you cannot think positively with negative feeling any more than you could think negatively with positive feeling. Therefore, your first two lessons of creative psycho-cybernetics are, one, that you have a self-image and that you can improve it. The second step or lesson is that you have a self-servo mechanism or success mechanism that steers your mind to a productive goal, which is what psycho-cybernetics really is. Your third important lesson teaches you that you can use your imagination either constructively or destructively. You are the product of your imagination, win, lose, or draw. If a boy at school thinks he's stupid because he was told he was stupid, he will act and prove to the world that he is stupid. The whole secret of reaching self-fulfillment and self-respect and success as a human being by remembering, and remembering only this, that is the opinion of yourself that counts. If you think well of yourself because of some accomplishment and have that confidence which brings a smile to your self-image, you will succeed. On the other hand, if you think in negative terms because of some frustration, believing that you are a failure because of that one error, you will fail unless you change your self-image like Anna did. A mistake doesn't make a failure. The business of living is to rise above a mistake. That's what success is, not just being successful. The whole business of success is the capacity to rise above a blunder, a failure. And that's how you do it, by using your imagination constructively. Not only to think creatively, but act creatively. You learn to reach your goal by exercising your servo mechanism, your success mechanism, refusing to be sidetracked by negative feeling. If you think well of yourself because of some accomplishment and have that confidence which brings a smile to your self-image, you will succeed. On the other hand, if you think in negative terms because of some frustration, believing that you are a failure because of that one error, you will fail unless you change your self-image like Anna did. A mistake doesn't make a failure. The business of living is to rise above a mistake. That's what success is, not just being successful. The whole business of success is the capacity to rise above a blunder, a failure. And that's how you do it, by using your imagination constructively. Not only to think creatively, but act creatively. You learn to reach your goal by exercising your servo mechanism, your success mechanism, refusing to be sidetracked by negative feeling. You learn to do one thing at a time. You learn to live in the present. The past is forgotten, lost in the tomb of time. Beliefs become habits, and habits are nothing more than self-hypnosis, just like you learn to brush your teeth. You must learn that happiness belongs to you, like your eyes, like your heart, like your pulse. You reach for it. But when you reach for it, you must remember that you must not step on other people's toes, and what's equally important, you must not step on your own toes with negative feeling. Regardless of your age, regardless of your calling, regardless of your training, experience, or education, one thing common to every human being is the desire to be happy. The eighth lesson...